Hello, and welcome to the fourth episode of our Frequently Asked Questions series. This week's episode, we'll be looking at everything from default IP addresses to what you will need for a basic camera setup. So let's get started with question number one. What is the default username, password, and IP address of my camera? Now, if you know anything about IP addresses or default passwords, then you might think this question is quite easy. But when it comes to IP cameras, it can differ massively depending on the brand. For example, some brands will use the traditional username of admin and a 12345 or 12345 6 password. Some will use root as the username and others will use repeated numbers like this. And some will have a password that is the same as the username or use the model number of the camera. In terms of default IP addresses, again, it comes down to which brands you use. Some will use the standard 192.0.0.6.4. Others use addresses ranging from 192.168.0.1 to 192.168.0.2.5.3. While some brands default to DHCP, this is where the camera connects to a different IP address every time you try to connect to it. At the moment, all of these defaults are still a security risk for two main reasons. One, everyone knows what they are, and two, people forget to change their defaults. Now, to you personally, this might not seem like a big issue, but on a global scale, it could be hugely damaging, because these default passwords, usernames, and IP addresses can be used in something called a DDoS attack. This is where a hacker hijacks your IP devices using these default details and brings hundreds of thousands of devices together to try and access a website or server all at the same time. This causes something called a denial of service. This is where the network is so clogged with traffic that the website or server trying to be accessed will crash. And with more and more IP devices being bought and left on default, these attacks will only get bigger and more damaging. Currently, there are a few brands like Hikvision trying to improve this by requiring their customers to enter a unique username and password before accessing their cameras. But at the moment, there are still a lot of brands that don't, and so if you wish to find the default of your brand of camera, simply search for it online. And then once you're logged in, please remember to set your defaults to something completely unique using a password software like LastPass. Question 2. Why can't I stream my Hikvision cameras via Google Chrome? This is a question we had quite a lot over the last 18 months or so, and the answer comes down to browser security and video plugins. The main problem is a plugin called MPAPI, which allows unrecognized video formats and codecs to be streamed through a browser. The problem is that this plugin is now over 15 years old and still based on a 90s computer architecture, which as current browsers become more and more advanced, is causing a whole heap of problems from crashes to security breaches. And because of these security problems, some of these browsers, including Opera, Microsoft Edge, some versions of Internet Explorer, and now Chrome, have removed this plugin from all of their latest versions of their browsers. Since the Chrome announcement in 2015, there have been calls for Hikvision to find a way around this problem, but up to the date of recording this video in March 2017, there is yet to be any official fix released. But it's likely this will change very soon because as of the beginning of March 2017, Firefox has now also removed the plugin, leaving you just Safari and some versions of Internet Explorer as your only option. Question number 3. I don't know much about computers or IP cameras, but I would like to set up a basic system. Where do I start? This is probably one of the most frequently asked questions for our customer support team, and I think they and you, the customers, will be very happy to have it quickly summarized in this video. So obviously the first thing you'll need for a basic setup is cameras. And because we're talking about basic setup, we'll use the example of someone who has bought 2 to 4 cameras. Now you're going to want to power these cameras. For this, there are two options. Most IP cameras can be powered the old-fashioned way with a 12-volt power supply. But if your cameras are wired or you're thinking about adding possibly more cameras at a later date, we would suggest using PoE. This is a system where power and data are sent across the same length of cable. This greatly reduces installation time and cost. To get PoE to your cameras, you will have to either use an MVR, which we'll talk about later, or a PoE switch / injector, which attaches or injects power to your data signal as it passes through. Next is storage, which is the key reason that we use security cameras, to record and store evidence of things that we might not be present for, such as burglaries or vandalism. You basically have two options for storing footage from your cameras. One is to install a micro SD card, such as the one you find in your smartphone, and record to that. Or the second option is to use network storage, such as a NAS or MVR. Now, which option you choose to use is down to the number of cameras you have and the resolution that you record at. So say, for example, you had 2 to 4 cameras and they were all recording under 4 megapixels, then recording to microSD would be perfectly fine. But if you're installing a system with, say, 10 or more cameras and all of them are recording at 4 megapixels or higher, then recording to an MVR with terabytes of storage space is probably a more time and cost-saving way to go. If you want to work out exactly the amount of storage space you will need for your system, you can use our online storage calculator, which you will find at our forum by following the link up here in the video or down here in the description. The final component is viewing and managing your cameras. There are 3 options for doing this, the first of which is using a smartphone app. But this is only if the brand has an app, and also it should only be used in conjunction with one of the other options and not as your only point of access. The second way of managing your cameras is via a computer. This can either be done by using a browser to access each camera directly, or by installing VMS to your computer and using that to access all of your cameras on the network at once. And the final option is connecting a monitor and a mouse directly to an MVR and operating the recorder like a desktop computer. All of these options will allow you to control the same features, and so no one option is better than any other, although we should point out that some features will not be controllable via the app depending on which brand you pick, so double check before buying. Now obviously there are a lot of other network components you might want to add to your system, such as alarms, VoIP phones or door entry systems, but these are more job specific and less to do with basic setup. Although we will probably come back in another video and talk about these products in more detail and how to add them to your system. Thank you for watching and subscribing. We hope you found this video very helpful. If you haven't subscribed already, please do by clicking down here. Check the description below for links to our Facebook, Twitter and Google Plus feeds. Follow the link here for our webshop. And if you want more videos like this, click on the playlist up here. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.